What's up, guys, and welcome back to the channel for another video. Well, it happened and AMD just had their official Zen 3 reveal event, and wow, we have some things to talk about. But before we get started, it would help me out a ton if you all abuse that like button if you end up enjoying the video, so that way YouTube will be less tempted to kill the video altogether. Your support means an awful lot, but now let's talk GPU tech. Now, in my opinion, AMD put on a great to the point show, and at the end, they even decided to spoil us and give us a glimpse at the RX 6000 series Big Navi GPU, aka the supposed RX 6900 XT, in action with a few benchmarks. At first, AMD showed us actual gameplay running Borderlands 3 at 4K Ultra settings, demonstrating how smooth the performance is, but did not provide us with any on-screen metrics to draw direct comparisons for us to gauge performance. And sure enough, as soon as my disappointment with that set in, they gave us three benchmarks on screen that show us what Big Navi and Zen 3 are capable of when working together. At 4K paired with a Ryzen 5000 series CPU, Big Navi was able to push out an average of 61 frames per second on Borderlands 3 maxed out, 88 frames per second on Call of Duty Modern Warfare on Ultra, and 73 FPS on Gears 5 at Ultra settings. Now, this is the kind of data we were all waiting for. So what comparisons can we draw to figure out how fast Big Navi will be compared to the competition over at Nvidia? Well, honestly, it depends what benchmarks you're looking at and what hardware configuration the user is using for it, but on average, Big Navi performs a little under RTX 3080 performance levels at 4K resolution, but it's really not that far behind. Of course, as you can expect, we didn't hear anything about price during today's show for Big Navi, but if rumors circulating from insiders are correct, in that AMD plans on pricing Big Navi at around $500 to $550 at launch, then Team Red will be able to obtain almost RTX 3080 levels of performance for around $200 to $150 less of a cost, while also sporting an extra 6GB more of VRAM. Now, take that information with a grain of salt, after all it is rumors, and this is certainly exciting if it ends up all coming together, but one thing I want to discuss that I mentioned earlier, these benchmarks shown to us today by AMD were done on a Ryzen 5000 series CPU, and I'm going to assume they chose their most powerful one to pair up with Big Navi for these benchmarks. Now, I'm going to save most of the details on Zen 3 for a separate video for tomorrow, but during the event, AMD stated that Zen 3 can provide as much as a 26% performance boost while gaming compared to their previous generation. That being said, your everyday user not using that same level of CPU used for these benchmarks will of course notice a deeper variance in performance than seen here, but don't let that scare you, because at 4K resolutions, CPU bottlenecks tend to scale down and become less significant. So until we all have this hardware in our hands to collect our own data, we can't say for sure how deep of a delta we could experience between AMD's RX 6900X XT and Nvidia's RTX 3080 for sure, but these benchmarks do take the worst case scenario out of the equation of Big Navi only competing with the RTX 3070 and below. Of course, I don't pick sides when it comes to these kinds of things. If anything, I'm on the side of the consumer, and the more competition we have, the better it'll be for all of us, but I want to know what you all think about today's show. Does it make you more excited for RDNA 2, or did today crumple some expectations? Let me know down in the comments below. That's all I really wanted to talk about in today's update concerning Big Navi. Thank you so much for taking the time to watch the video. As always, it's been my pleasure, fam. Please stay safe, stay happy, and keep on gaming.